the morning.
It's day four. Right, puppy?
I need to get upstairs and start working, so we're gonna try to get ready pretty fast. We're gonna let that marinate while I wash my face. I wanna pick at these zits, but I know I shouldn't. So the company I work for is a contracting company. So while I work for my company, we work for other people. People call us and contract us to do work for them. So I get to work for a lot of companies, and it's really cool. I've been able to see a lot of stuff. Last year, if you've been here for a while, I traveled to Dubai, Mexico, Brazil, and Singapore for work. I was supposed to also go to Egypt, but Egypt ended up not working out, which actually was like the one I was most sad about. Dubai was very cool, and so were Singapore was actually really cool. I would say Singapore is like if Dubai got homey, got cozy. Like, Dubai is exactly what you see on the internet. There are no cars on the road that have like, that need work. Like, there's not like dents, scratches. They're all, I don't know, maybe 2020 and newer. Like, it's very glitz, glamour. I went to the Dubai Mall, the biggest mall in the world. It is quite crazy. There's an aquarium in it. The whole city is glitz and glamour and new and shiny and technology and the whole city. You can't even chew gum or drink water on the train or like the subway. Like, it is like a finable offense because they want to keep the city nice and whatever. If Dubai got cozy and I didn't feel like if I didn't have $1 million that I was out of place, that would be Singapore. They have some really, really cool technology. They have newer cars. Like, there are no cars on the road that look like they got in a wreck. They need work, dents, scratches, whatever. But they have so much greenery. Like, it's less focused on the glitz and glam, and it's more focused on sustainability. There are plants and living plants, like flowers and green things, woven into the architecture of almost all the buildings. There are plants in every building. They're like their co-working space, or just like, it's all just very sustainable, but in like a fancy way. I don't know, it just kind of felt a little more cozy, but Singapore was so cool. That's not the point of what I was saying. The point of what I was saying was, we're a contracting company. I kind of forgot what we were saying. What I was saying. We are a contracting company, so other companies hire us to do their things. So, a company has hired us to do work for them, and I did work for them in 2022 and early 2023, and I actually didn't like it. It's not that I didn't like the work, actually. I didn't love I don't even know how to describe it, because I don't want to say the company, because when you're a contractor, obviously I have a boss, but when we go work for other people, I kind of end up with a second boss and someone I report to at that company, especially with contracts that are longer term. And the boss at that company was great. We got along so well. Honestly, he was great to work for. And I don't know. Maybe it was the culture, or it wasn't my jam. Also, we had somebody else on the project and she was let go. So I had to take her project. So that might be another underlying reason of why I didn't like it, was because I wasn't supposed to be on it in the first place, and it like disrupted what I was already doing, and I was kind of annoyed. So that could also be part of it. But I am a team lead for our company, so there are things that I get to do because I worked for this position. And so there are things that I get to do that not everyone gets to do because I'm the team lead. And this position at this company when that I had to abruptly go on, we could have just hired somebody new and taught them how to do this. It in no way needs to be a team lead. It just happened to be a contract that was in Louisville, and here I am. And I'm a team player. So when my boss was like, we need help with this, I was like, I can handle it. That's fine. And I knew there was an end. I knew that the contract was only X amount of months. So I was like, okay, I can do this. It's fine. So it ended last spring, and I was like, oh, thank God, I'm done with that. And now they want us again. We tried to say that we were going to put somebody else on it. Like, we were going to hire somebody, because like I said, this, we could teach someone to do this who is new to our team. It doesn't need to be me as a team lead. It's not something that's more challenging or requires more experience that they would benefit or that they need me or another team lead. But the boss at this company really likes me, which I love. So he like requested me specifically. And so I have to go back and I am annoyed again. And it's, like I said, it has nothing to do with the people, I think. It's just that when I go, it's a longer term contract, so they contract one of us, somebody on our company, for 40 hours a week for months. So I'm nervous about growth in my company while I'm there, because I'm supposed to be giving 40 hours to this client, and then I have no room on my plate to be a team lead and have leadership responsibilities and things like that. So I'm not super excited about it. And it is the beginning of March. It was supposed to be April, and they changed it to the beginning of March. So every day that passes, I'm like, oh my God, it's happening. So we'll see how 75 hard works when I have to go into the office. But honestly, I think it will help, because anyone who's thinking about it, maybe this will be a little bit more realistic. I think working from home is one thing. Like, people who do this and are full-time content creators, it's a little unrealistic, because you're like, I have a job and all these things. I also have a job, but I have a little bit more balance that other people don't because I work from home. And I recognize that. So we'll see how it goes when I have to go into the office. And it's a longer contract, which I also see, this is me just complaining when I should just be saying, I'm so glad I have a job. Like, that I have a steady paycheck and insurance and a 401k. But anyways, I'm gonna complain. This contract is until Thanksgiving, and I don't like longer term contracts because I like moving from thing to thing. I like, okay, this is 6 weeks. I start it, I do the middle, I finish it, and then I get something new, and they're usually different. And that's what I like about my company. So I don't like love longer projects. I said I was gonna take 10 minutes, and here we are. I'm gonna try to do this quick. The one thing about having these bangs is it makes me want to do my hair every day because, or maybe I feel like I have to do my hair every day. Otherwise, they look weird. I'm gonna knock things off my counter. Ooh, Nolly. I gave myself some very quick curls, and I think I wanna try to do my bangs different. That doesn't involve rollers. I might regret it, but this is like day 5 hair, so we can always wash it later. Okay, barrel out. Nope, this way. And curled backwards, but sideways. Oh, what? Why did that work so much better than the curlers? I still kind of like the curlers if I have. Why do I keep saying that? The rollers? If I have time to let them sit and stuff. But this was, okay. Out. Oop. That way. Oh, that one was way better. Should we try this one again? Sure. Why not? That doesn't need to be involved. But this way. Oh, maybe I should start doing them like that from now on. Those are cutie patootie.
Breakfast burrito, Chick-fil-A sauce, our hot girl coffee with 20 grams of protein. They're French vanilla collagen. Nolly's collar is charging. Somebody's a naked noodle. Let's see what our day list is today. Flannel Indie Country Thursday morning. Noah Kahn, Zach Bryan, The Good Neighbors. Do we like that? Oh, Drew Holcomb and The Neighbors. Okay. We can jam with this for a little bit. I just had two meetings in a row, and I technically have three meetings in a row, but I have 2 minutes before my next meeting, and I don't actually have to talk on that meeting. I just have to listen, and it's an hour. So I think this is the perfect time to take the little girl for a thing and listen to my meeting while we get workout number one out of the way.
Ooh. Oh, you don't even have your collar on. Get your steps in. You can't be a naked noodle.
It looks like it's about to rain, so hopefully we can beat this rain. But also, my dad was on my front porch the exact moment I walked out my back door. And neither of us saw the other one. He was bringing me Valentine's candy. I have felt like two or three drops, and we are one street away from home. So fingers crossed, we make it before it starts pouring. Nolly, we might need to pick it up. We made it back just in time. Look at all those raindrops coming down. Didn't we? Good job, girl. Gosh. From my dad, I forgot to get it earlier when we came back from our walk. These are at Costco. The fridge is stocked with the Kevins. I actually really like the Kevins. We have a couple different kinds of those. This beef stroganoff, which also is gluten-free. And these beef sirloin strips are the best. But this is one of the Costco meals, and I think this one I'm gonna eat for lunch. It says you can just cook it in the microwave. So let's just do that. Okay, it's going in here for 4 minutes. And so this says 16 grams of protein. So one serving, 16 grams of protein, 30 carbs, 9 grams of fat. So that's not bad, except 16 grams of protein is for toddlers. Let's beef this up. So since this is chicken, I know. Come here. This better be chicken. This is tuna. No, there's chicken. Get out of here. There's chicken back here. I know it. Behind all these stupid snacks. Oh, my gosh. Ugh. Chicken. Also Costco. But I love these because this is, if this weirds you out, sorry. This is cooked chicken already in this can. And it is, see. Well, okay. There are 3-ish servings per can. So if you ate a whole can, you'd get almost 40 grams of protein just out of this can. We're gonna maybe do half a can, and then this gives us almost 40 grams of protein. You don't have to always follow recipes. And I'm actually doing it. Here's the first YouTube video. I'm hoping I will upload it here in like 2 seconds. We are running late. Oops. For the gym. Put some pre-workout in here. Also, if you are seeing this before the end of February, if you buy any First Form supplements with my link, anybody's link, if you buy a supplement through somebody's link, you will get free access to their app for 30 days. This is just the month of February, so if you see this after February, so sorry. But you'll get 30 days free to the app. Also, shamelessly, I use the First Form app for my personal training clients. So if you want to be a personal training client, you could get 30 days free to the app, and then I can be your trainer, and then some of the costs is covered. Just saying, okay, let's go.
This is irrelevant, but I'm fired up about it, so we're gonna talk. What is with this NCAA volleyball rule change? There's two rule changes. One is that you can have two liberos. I'm 50-50 on that one. I'm not for it or against it. I know that all the teams I was on, we had very good defense to the point where the libero could change at any time. Two of my best friends were my liberos at some point in my life while we were all on the same team. Sometimes they would switch jerseys and whatever. So the two libero rule, I can see why it would help, but also that means you have two players who get unlimited subs, because that's the point of a libero, is you don't have to sub. So I think that's a con. However, let's talk about the one that I'm fired up about, which is that setters can have double contact. And I'm sorry, but that is just, that's so stupid. I spent 16 years of my life, if not more, playing volleyball to the point where I played in college. Somebody paid me to come play for them, which, joke's on them, but whatever. And to the point where I matched a school record, and I should have gotten it, but that story is neither here nor there. But I worked my ass off to be able to set well and to set whatever pass was given to me, if it's not perfect, and still make a really good play out of it. Like, I had to work so hard to make sure that my hands were really good. And now you're taking all that work out of it, so anybody can be a setter, is what you're telling me. Like, that, I'm so heated. So heated. They said it's for gameplay and for fans. Fans don't want to see sloppy volleyball. Like, oh, I'm so fired up about it for no reason. Like, I'm a has-been. I shouldn't care, but I do, deeply. Gym done. So workout two done, and I finished another one of my water bottles. So 80 ounces down the hatch. And honestly, that didn't hurt my back too much, which is exciting because I've been having back pain since October. But tomorrow morning, I get an MRI to give us some more answers. So let's go home and eat dinner. Give me up. Oh, have you just been sleeping? Okay. You just burped in my face. Thank you. I was sitting on the couch and totally forgot that I have sand volleyball tonight. I play sand volleyball on Thursdays. So we're headed to go play sand. We won our sand game, but we had to play a lot harder than I think any of us anticipated. So hair wash day might be sooner than we thought. But we won, played really hard. I finished my gallon while I was there. Now we're gonna eat dinner and get ready for bed because I have an MRI at 5:45 in the morning.
Dinner is beef stroganoff with broccoli and a hot girl cherry Coke Zero. Making our nightly mocktail. With our peach magnesium.